we have very good evidence that incorporating the arts actually impacts healing. Healing in various dimensions. It may be healing that you actually get out of hospital faster. This has been shown. Very interesting study. This was a study looking at people who had surgery. And they had this kind of interesting kooky design, randomized design, where patients who had a window that opened up onto like a brick wall versus a window that opened out onto a natural scene. The latter, the people who had a window that opened out onto the natural world, had less analgesic requirements, got out of hospital sooner, and had less reporting kind of negative, feeling not as well in the nurse's notes about them. And that's, you know, again, these very small, simple measures. When we think of how our hospitals are built these days, oftentimes, you know, you can't see out a window. There's no window to see out of. Or if there is, you can't open it, you know. We know from, you know, you talk about, you know, multimodal kinds of things, music. We know from neonatal intensive care units the kinds of things that music can do for an ill neonate, that they actually put on weight faster. There's reduced hospital stay with being exposed to music, you know? And we did, you're reminding me of another aspect of research that we were involved with, which was we've got very good evidence that music makes a difference for neonatal care. So we weren't looking at that piece, but what we wanted to see was, what was the effect of having music on staff, on the nurses? Because one of the things that we found, and this was when we had funding for a music therapist that we no longer have, and that's why I said they need to be on par. When we would have our music therapist come and be present with a family who was facing end of life of their neonate. So this would be in situations where we might be foregoing ventilatory support of an ill neonate. And the music therapist would be at the bedside and talk with the family about what kinds of things would support them through this time, musically. That not only did we have amazing feedback from the family in terms of how comforted they felt through having that available to them. But we heard from the nurses who came up and said, gosh, that was so helpful for us because we've been spending so much time with this family and really got to know them so well that we really appreciate it. We knew that you were coming to provide the music therapy for the family and for their infant, but boy, it really helped us be present during that time of foregoing the ventilatory support. So we began to think, you know, wouldn't it be interesting to find out what kinds of benefits there are for nursing staff? And this study was actually having a music therapist play live music for 30 minutes, you know, which you think, well, 30 minutes in a day, how helpful is that? But it's kind of like, you know, people talk about inoculation. That 30 minutes actually has carryover effect. So even though you're only playing for 30 minutes and hearing it for 30 minutes, it actually has some, it stays with you. And that's what we heard from the people that we interviewed as part of this research project. The nurses said, oh my gosh, you know, that made a huge difference in my day. You've got to find a way of continuing to support that. And it's not supported, you know. It's very rare to have those kinds of services, which it really is a service, supported through conventional care settings. You know, you can imagine with budgetary constraints and fiscal realities that people say, the arts, you know, it's nice, but it's a fringe. what I think we need to get out there is that it's actually not, that if we use it concurrently, it helps the patients that are receiving care, helps their families, and it helps the staff who are there providing care. And I know that, and I think when we talk to people, many people will, you know, they'll say, oh yeah, you know, I've felt that myself, or it's amazing, you know, when you look at hospital environment and what kinds of things are there, you know, what helps you feel more relaxed, more hopeful, more whatever. I mean, McDonald's makes use of that, right? When they paint a certain color, so you have your meal and you're done and you get up and go. You know, they use this with intentionality. Well, we should use this with intention in providing care, and actually look at it wisely, so that when we build our structures where we care for people. I mean, there's all kinds of ways that we can use it, but it requires thinking about it and being intentional about it and having the funding to support it. And it's not a fringe. I think what we need to do is back up what we innately know with some evidence and research, so we can say to folks, look, not only does it feel good to have this, because it's something that we innately all do as humans, I think, but wow, you know, it's actually had an effect on patient satisfaction, on how families feel. It's got reduced hospital stays and, you know, better healing and, you know, all those kinds of things, which is starting to develop a body of evidence around the arts and healthcare intersection. But I think we need to beef that up, get that out there, and have some supportive funding around that, and not consider it as kind of extra. Art's very personal. So you can imagine, you know, you bring 10 of us into a white, you know, painted hospital room and say, what would you like in your room? Well, 10 of us would pick 10 different things. So I think we need some evidence to inform what actually is reassuring to people, what does feel comforting and hopeful. There's some wonderful interventions where there's something called the art cart, much like a loaning library with books, and you wheel it into patient's room. It's got a whole array of various pieces of art, and it's a loaner. And a patient can say, you know, or if they're not responsive and it's a family member, they can pick something that for them has value and comfort, and they put it up on that, you know, on their wall. We need some evidence to say, is that helpful for people, and in what way, and what's most helpful? So I don't think it's research to say, should we do it or not? It's research to say, in what way do we do it so that it's most supportive of people? I think we need to just do it, but do it in a way that really is supportive of people. And I think for that we need to be better informed about how can we provide that in a way that's most helpful to people. Hopeful, there you go, Freudians. But it's hope is a part of it, I think, as well. You know, it's connecting with things that help ground people, help them feel better, and support them as they're going through difficult times in their lives.